transmission parameters of a two port network. So before we solve the numericals, let me briefly revise. So you have a two port network which is shown, and this two port network has an input voltage V1, output voltage V2. The current that is entering the input side is represented as I1, and the current that is leaving the network is represented as I2. So we can define the two port network using the transmission parameters as V1 to be equal to AV2 minus BI2, and I1 to be equal to CV2 minus DI2. And in the matrix form, we can write this as V1 I1 to be equal to ABCD, and this is V2 minus of I2. Remember, there is a negation sign corresponding to the output current that is leaving the network, that is minus of I2. So when you solve the numericals, you have to substitute the value of current by minus 1 whenever you have the current, output current I2. So we look into that when we solve the numericals. Okay, now individually, if you want to compute the transmission parameters, that is A is computed as V1 by V2 with output current I2 to be equal to 0, and B is computed as V1 by minus I2 with V2 equal to 0. C is computed as I1 by V2 with I2 equal to 0, and D is computed as I1 by I2, that is minus I2 with V2 equal to 0. You can see here we have I2 equal to 0, I2 equal to 0, V2 equal to 0, and V2 equal to 0. So if you want to compute the parameters A and C, what you need to do? If you want to compute A and C, then you need to open circuit the output side, keep the output side open circuited, and you need to connect which voltage? Voltage V1 at the input. Whereas if you want to find the parameter B and D, you are supposed to short circuit the output side, that is V2 equal to 0, here the current I2 equal to 0, and here you need to connect the voltage source V1 at the input side. So you can see the difference. Here output is open circuited, here output is short circuited. A will be called as the open circuit voltage ratio. Open circuit because I2 is equal to 0. So this is open circuit voltage ratio. B, you can see, is computed by shorting the output side, and this is called as negative short circuit transfer impedance. Negative because you have a negative value of current. Coming to the parameter C, this is obtained by open circuiting the output side, and this will be called as the open circuit transfer admittance. Admittance because it is I by V. Then parameter D, again you have negative value of current. So this is referred to as negative short circuit current ratio. Now coming to the equation for reciprocity. For reciprocity, in this particular case, or to find whether the network is reciprocal, we need to verify the condition AD minus BC to be equal to 1. Other than this, you also have symmetry concept. There you need to check whether all these parameters A, B, C and D are same. Okay. Now, when I said for reciprocity AD minus BC should be equal to 1, you should remember that this condition will be satisfied when there are no dependent sources. Determine the ABCD parameters for the network shown and verify the condition of reciprocity. Also remember, these ABCD parameters are also referred to as the T parameters, okay? Transmission parameters, or it's also called as the T parameters. So if you look at this particular circuit, what do you see? You are having the resistances to be the same here, 3 ohms, 3 ohms, 3 ohms. So instead of complicating the circuit, what we can do is we can represent this delta connection, that is 3 ohms, 3 ohms, 3 ohms. Let me mark this. So I can convert this into a star. So the delta connection can be converted to a star connection. All you need to do is you need to find out the equivalent resistance. In this case, this is equal to the resistance in the star network will be equal to 1 by 3 the resistance in the delta network. So it is 1 by 3 into 3, which is equal to 1 ohms. So let me draw the equivalent circuit. This is 1 ohms, 1 ohms, this is 1 ohms. This was obtained from the star connection. Then you have 3 ohms here. Or I can directly write this as 1 ohm plus 3 ohms, which is equal to 4 ohms. Now to compute the individual parameters, you can use current divider rule, voltage divider rule. You can use the KVL at the input side, KVL at the output side. So this is a simple T network that you have here. So apply the KVL and use the current divider rules and compute. So first let me draw the circuit for computing A and C. So to compute A and C, I will have the circuit wherein I have to connect a voltage source at the input side. This is 1 ohms. This total resistance, let me write it 4 ohms. And then I have voltage V1. So if I apply KVL at the input side or to the mesh 1, the current that is flowing across this is I1 and this is I2. Remember, this current I2 is equal to 0 and the current that is flowing across this 4 ohm resistance is I1 plus I2. Because both the currents are entering. So when I apply KVL to the mesh 1, I have V1 minus 1 into I1 minus 4 I1 plus I2 equal to 0. Since I2 is equal to 0, I have V1 to be equal to 5 I1. Now, when this current I2 is equal to 0, the voltage across this 1 ohm resistance is equal to 0. It is equivalent to saying we do not have a 1 ohm resistance. So if you want to compute this voltage V2, how do you compute? The voltage V2 which is appearing at this particular node now. So this will be computed using the voltage division rule. So using voltage division rule, I can compute V2 to be equal to, see, this is the voltage. It is equivalent to saying voltage V1, the resistance 1 ohm and the resistance 4 ohm is connected in series. This voltage is V2, correct? This is at ground potential. So when I compute the voltage divider rule, V2 will be equal to V1 into the resistance, the other end of the resistance, that is 4 ohms, divided by the total resistance. The resistance across which you are going to compute has to be multiplied with V1. So V1 into 4 divided by 1 plus 4. So this will be 4V1 by 5. Okay. Now, you need to compute A. So what is A? A is equal to V1 by V2 with I2 equal to 0. Rearrange this and this will be equal to V1 by V2 will be equal to 5 by 4. Then we need to compute C. C is I1 by V2 with I2 equal to 0. If you look at this equation from applying KVL to the mesh 1, let me name this as equation number 1 and this as equation number 2. You can see V1 is equal to 5 times I1, right? What we want for C is I1 by V2. So substitute V1 is equal to 5 by 4 V2 in this equation. So rearranging equation 2, you have V1 is equal to 5 by 4 V2. So substitute this in the first equation. So after applying KVL, what you had got? You had got V1 to be equal to 5I1, or I can write this as 5 by 4 V2 is equal to 5I1. This and this gets cancelled. Therefore, C is equal to I1 by V2 with I2 equal to 0, which is equal to 1 by 4. What is the unit of this? This is admittance, unit is S. Next, you have finished computing A and C. Next, you need to find out B and D. So to find B and D, you have to connect the voltage source V1 at the input side. You have the 1 ohm resistance, you have the 4 ohm resistance, and you have the 1 ohm resistance again, and this is shorted. That is V2 is equal to 0. So again, in this case, apply KVL to the mesh 1. And you get this as V1 minus, this current is I1, this current is I2, current flowing across this 4 ohm is I1 plus I2. So V1 minus 1 ohm into I1 minus 4 times I1 plus I2 equal to 0. equation number 3. Now, use the current division rule in order to find out the relationship between I1 and I2, because using that you can clearly find out what is B. Okay, so before that, find out or use the current divider rule. So you can compute I2 to be equal to minus, because the direction of current is opposite, minus I1 into the resistance that is in the opposite branch, which is equal to 4 divided by the total resistance connected in the parallel combination here. So that is 1 plus 4. So remember how we are considering the value of the total resistance. This is 4 plus 1. So this value will be equal to minus 4 by 5 I1. Now if you look at the parameter D, D is equal to I1 divided by minus I2 with V2 equal to 0. I1 by I2, so this is equal to 5 by 4. Next, you need to substitute the value of the current I2 in equation 3 and find out the value of V1 with respect to I2 so that you can find out the parameter B. So this can be written as V1 is equal to minus 5 by 4 I2 plus 4 I2. V1 is equal to how much? Minus 9 by 4 I2. Rearrange this 9 by 4 ohms because it is impedance. Next, what they have asked is, if you see the question, they have asked to verify the condition for reciprocity. So let us first write all the ABCD parameters, ABCD, and this is equivalent to, then you have B to be equal to 9 by 4, C is equal to 1 by 4, and D is equal to 5 by 4. So condition for reciprocity that you have is AD minus BC should be equal to 1. So substitute 5 by 4 into 5 by 4 minus 1 by 4 into 9 by 4. This is equal to 1. And we can say the network is reciprocal. Otherwise also, when you look at the circuit, you can clearly identify because there are no dependent sources. And by verifying mathematically also, we have proved the same.